Excerpt number 15 from Peace in the World by Bala Sulam. The collective and the individual are one and the same, and the individual is not harmed because of his enslavement to the collective, since the freedom of the collective and the freedom of the individual are one and the same too. And as they share the good, they also share the freedom. Thus, good attributes and bad attributes, good deeds and bad deeds, are evaluated only with respect to the benefit of the public. Of course, the above words apply if all the individuals perform their role toward the public to the fullest and receive no more than they deserve, nor take from their friends' share. But if a part of the collective does not behave accordingly, as a result, they not only harm the collective, but they too are harmed. We should not discuss further something that is known to all, and the aforesaid is only to show the drawback, the place that needs correction, namely that each and every individual will understand that his own benefit and the benefit of the collective are one and the same, and by this the world will come to its full correction.
Well, if we can't see any questions, so maybe you should repeat it. Oh, Hebrew 10. Go ahead.
Thank you, Rav. What does it mean, the freedom of the collective?
The freedom of the collective. What is freedom? It's when one feels that he can freely do whatever the truth requires of him. What is truth? The truth is that force that acts in the entire reality. It's the Creator. If he may carry out all the actions with adherence to the Creator, whatever the Creator wants, whatever this upper force, what nature requires of him, this is called, he is in freedom. When will he be in freedom? When he's in freedom from the angel of death, from his ego. To that extent, he will be free. To the extent that he helps the public to reach such freedom, meaning eternity, when everything is connected to that upper force, only then do we come out of life and death, all the troubles, all the problems, etc. This is called being free. Yes.
But we see today in the world that all those freedoms actually give the ego a certain place to let itself loose, doesn't let itself check itself.
Yeah, but where do you see freedom in the world? How do you define it?
Today, they define as one of the most important principles in democracy, which is freedom.
Meaning that anyone can do whatever he feels like according to his ego.
Well, that's opposite freedom.
So, yeah, that's opposite freedom.
So, that's what I'm saying. How can we explain that true freedom is what you explained right now?
First of all, if I'm in my own nature, the way I was born, and it binds me to all kinds of desires, intentions, and thoughts, and events which don't depend on me. That's what nature puts me in. So being in freedom is to get rid of all that. When can I say that I'm free? When I'm not under the influence of any force in reality, not the force of reception, nor the force of bestowal, no force. When does that happen to a person? When a person reaches a restriction. That's the central point of his development. When I can restrict myself, doesn't matter by what forces, by what help from above, but from the restriction on, I begin to define myself as a free person. decide either here or there. And the truth is, the freedom we reach is incorporated of two parts, both the force of reception and the force of bestowal, and I use them both equally and fully. That's why I don't get rid of any force in nature. I just know what's the whole manner by which I can use them together. That's called freedom.
Barur.